once every 4 minutes it would take to get a full turn, and that, of course, would be turning the lens at the same rate, a full turn every 4 minutes. If you look up into the lens, you can see that there's four panels of red. So that meant wherever you were out to sea, one panel of red would come in your direction once every minute. And that would create a, because of the bullseye lens that was located there, that would give you about a 5 second very intense bright flash of light, of red light. Then there'd be a break in the light, and then you get about 30 seconds of white light, and then there'd be another break in the light, and then the next thing to come would be the red flash again, and the pattern would start over. The significance of this is that that was the signature of this lighthouse. So every lighthouse along the coastline had a different light flashing pattern, and so that's called the signature. So if you were a sailor out at sea at night and you were looking at the flashing of a lighthouse, you could check your charts and books by watching the lightning and be able to identify, oh, that's the Cape Meares Lighthouse, and you could keep track of your location along the coastline. And they tried to build the lighthouses frequently enough so that before you lost the sight of one lighthouse, you'd be picking up view of the next lighthouse. This lighthouse could be seen out to sea for 21 and a half nautical miles. Well, the reason you couldn't see it further wasn't because of the limits of the light, but because of the curvature of the earth. So you'd be far enough over the horizon that you simply couldn't look back and see it anymore.